So in today's gospel, we have the continuation of the one we heard yesterday and day before, and Jesus condemns the dreadful pseudo-religion of the Pharisees. And three charges are leveled against the scribes. They were expert in the law. They laid upon people 1,001 burdens of the ceremonial law. But they did not keep them themselves, because they were experts in invasion tactics. It is incredible that people should ever have thought that God could have laid down laws like legalistic one, and that the working out of such details was a religious service, and the keeping of them a matter of life and death. But that was scribal religion. A little wonder that Jesus turned on the scribes, and that the scribes regarded him as an irreligious heretic. And secondly, the attitude of the scribes to the prophets was paradoxical. They profess a deep admiration for the prophets, but the only prophets they admired were dead. When they met a living one, they tried to kill him. They honor the dead prophets with tombs and memorials, but they dishonored the living ones with persecution and death. The prophet Micaiah said, "What does the Lord require of you? To do justice and to love kindness and to walk humbly with your God." That was the essence of a prophetic message, and it was the very antithesis of scribal teaching. No wonder the scribes, with their external details, hated the prophets, and Jesus walked in the prophetic line. And finally, the scribes shut the people off from Scripture. Their interpretation of Scripture was so fantastic that it was impossible for the ordinary person to understand it. In their hands, Scripture became a book of riddles. In their mistaken ingenuity, they refused to see its plain meaning themselves, and they would not let anyone else see it either. So the scriptures had become a prerequisite of the expert and the dark mystery to the common person. None of this is so very out of date. There are still those who demand from others standards, which they themselves refuse to satisfy. There are still those whose religion is nothing other than formalism and legalism. And there are still those who make the word of God so difficult that the seeking mind of a common person is bewildered and does not know what to believe and to whom to listen. Amen.